Hello and welcome to Post to Post, the channel where we discuss all things hockey and all teams. And I had no intentions of making this follow-up video, but...
No, it's like after my bedtime.
We have some time to kill between periods of the Toronto game. And I think it was worthy of us to make a video just as a follow-up to clarify a few things on the Elias or Elias Anderson situation and maybe some things that we said in the previous video. And I wanted to do it because I think it's important that we listen to your guys' comments. Like, it's not like we just put a video out there and just don't care about what you guys say or anything. Like, we care about the feedback. We care about what you guys say. We might not agree with it all, but at least we take the time to respond and to do a follow-up video like this. So at least, even if you disagree with us, I hope that you respect that. And we enjoy interacting with you guys. So it's fun regardless. Now, there's been a lot of, not necessarily negative comments towards us, but negative comments towards Canadians in general. And by Canadians, I mean the Canadian players. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to give you an opportunity to respond on a few comments. One of the biggest complaints is that some people have said it nicely, some people have said it pretty rudely. I had a couple of private messages that said, basically, Canada is a disgrace to the sport of hockey, and that we're all divers, and it's the only way that we can win anything. And my response to that is, look, there's going to be embellishment in hockey. Sometimes there's going to be dives, sometimes there's going to be embellishment, different levels of embellishment. That's just what hockey is a little bit, unfortunately. Unfortunately, it's gamesmanship. And you're going to see that from Canada. You're going to see that from the United States. You're going to see that from Sweden and every other single country and nationality around the world. It's in the NHL. It's in the SHL. It's everywhere. So it has nothing to do with Canada. It's just, unfortunately, it's just part of the game. And it sucks, but that's just part of the game. It's gamesmanship. And so that's really frustrating to hear people from Sweden say that Canada is a joke and Canada is just a bunch of divers and it's the only way that they can win. And I mean... Go to YouTube and search NHL embellishments. Search NHL embellishments Sedin. You'll find lots. So it's not just Canadian players. It's not a nationality specific thing.
No.
It's just a thing of the sport, and that's what it is.
It is a bit of a sport specific thing, though.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
If there's diving, I don't think there's a lot of diving going on in the run of a normal game.
No.
And I think to the extent that there may have been in the past, I think diving in hockey is, well, first off, it's a penalty if you're caught at it, which is rare, but it happens. And the instant replays and the multiple camera angles are such that anyone who's diving or embellishing will, maybe not that particular play, but will eventually develop a reputation among the officials that that's the kind of thing they do. Mm-hmm. And the next time they throw their head back, even if it's a real penalty or should have been called, it won't be called because that person is known as an embellisher.
So, absolutely.
So that's how this thing eventually corrects itself. And I think you're right. It's not just particular countries or nations or even teams. I remember a YouTube video somebody put up of all the clips of Claude Julien when he was with Boston complaining about Montreal Canadiens diving.
Yeah.
And then it showed clips of all the Boston Bruin divers.
Yeah.
You know, and it was unbelievable how bad that was. Things I didn't even see when they'd actually happened, I don't think. And now Claude Julien is the coach of the team that I cheer for. And, you know, I have to deal with that. That's my problem. But as far as a national, like that particular game itself, I agreed with you. There's one penalty I might not have called if I was the ref on Sweden. But Sweden was undisciplined, and I won't.
There's no denying it. They took some silly penalties.
They took some silly, stupid penalties, the cross checks and that kind of thing.
If you don't think so, then you're biased.
You just got to watch the game again.
There was a penalty behind the net. I forget who it was. I think it was Dahlin or Dahlin or whatever you want to pronounce his name.
I'd say.
He played the puck along the boards, and then he backed up into a guy for an interference call. It was clearly interference.
Yeah, so, or a trip, like depending, you know, he backed up, not just part of the play he was trying to make, he backed up specifically to impede the progress of the Canadian player that was going behind the net. Absolutely a penalty, absolutely should have been called. He sits in the penalty box and he looks up at it on the screen and he still doesn't
Yeah.
You know, like realize that that's a penalty.
So it's a bit frustrating when I see a penalty like that and see people, and not just Swedish people, but anyone really, try and defend a penalty like that. And there were others like that too. And like you said, there were some that I wouldn't have personally called if I was a referee. And there were calls that weren't called that I probably would have called on both sides. And it wasn't just the Canada versus Sweden game that the reffing wasn't great. The USA versus Sweden game as well had some crappy non-calls, I guess. And it's like the referees, and I'm not saying this has anything to do with it, but there was a lot of comments saying that the referees just wanted Canada to win because they like North America.
Let me ask you some questions. Was the game played in Canada?
No.
Was the referee number one Canadian?
No.
Referee number two Canadian?
Nope.
Linesman number one Canadian?
Nope.
Linesman number two Canadian?
No.
Okay.
They were all from Europe.
Carry on.
Every single referee in that game, that gold medal game, was from Europe. So I don't get the mentality of favoring a North American team when all the referees are from Europe, just like Sweden. So, like I said, not that that has anything to do with it, but that just the argument that someone started there just was just pointless. In my opinion. So,
well, everyone's really bold and everyone's really a genius when they're on the internet, right? And everyone's 30 years old and really, you know, a full-grown adult when they're on the internet too, apparently. And so I'm not gonna taint all of Sweden by some of the comments that have been directed at you. I haven't really been reading them. I honestly don't care. I know you care and you should. It's your channel. But I don't obsess about the comments. And they're not writing to me. Like, I'm not the one who's getting the messaging. And you are.
Well, it's not, they're more complaining about us, really.
All
right. Well, I mean, somewhere. But it was mostly complaining about the IIHF or the refs or whatever. And I understand that there were some calls that should have gone Sweden's way and didn't. Or calls that went Canada's way and shouldn't. And that's going to happen in any game in any league. It sucks, but it happens. Look back to, I think it was 99, when the whole foot in the crease thing with Dallas and Dallas and Buffalo. Buffalo lost the entire, like, they lost the Stanley Cup basically due to that play. I mean, it really sucks, but it happens in sports. It's just what happens. And
it's not so much the things that happen to you, it's how you handle it. It's what you do with it, how you use that for motivation. If you get a silver medal and you don't want the silver, what you do is you use that experience to improve your play for next time, so you won't have to go through that again.
Well, here's how I see it. I understand the interest in not wanting the silver medal, but you have to lose to know how to win. That silver medal just isn't a medal. It's a representation of a loss that you need to remember and to motivate you to come back next year or the years to come to get that win. Look, Canada did it last year. And they got silver, and they came back, and they won gold this year. Next year, I fully expect Sweden to come out of the gates just rolling and probably take gold medal. I think it's very possible, and I hope they do it, because revenge is awesome in sports.
I do agree with one point you made after the video was made, that you agreed to, maybe that someone else had made. I wonder how necessary it is to have the silver medal presentation take place immediately after the game, like it does.
Yeah, I mentioned that before we filmed the video, and I forgot to mention it in the video.
I don't know if that's really a good idea to do that, and certainly if they didn't do that, there would be no controversy over what happened in this case. Although I'm not blaming that as the reason why we have controversy.
No, but I think it's completely unneeded to put those kids on the ice. They just the most devastating loss they've ever felt in their entire life, and they have to stand there in tears and watch Canada, you know, celebrate and stuff. I just don't think that's, what's the point of it? Like, just wait a couple days, or I don't know, do the ceremony in private, or just give them their medals and let them leave off the ice or something like that. They don't need to be on there. And
I don't know how they do things in Europe when there's a league championship, you know, within the Swedish Elite League or the you know, Swiss League, whatever. But in North America, when they play the Stanley Cup Final, in fact, when they play every playoff series leading up to the Stanley Cup Final, before the team can even lift the cup over their head, they get in a line and they shake hands with the opposing team. And I like it when the cameras focus on the players themselves. They often don't. That's another complaint I've got, but that's for another show. But the players are congratulating each other for a series well fought.
Yes.
And I can tell in their eyes, there's the same kind of disappointment. Can you imagine?
Nobody wants to be there.
Losing the Stanley Cup, of all things. But you know what? When they, you know, good game, shaking hands and hugging each other sometimes, it's genuine.
Oh, completely.
It's genuine. Yeah. And to me, that's the absolute best part of hockey as a sport, is that tradition of shaking hands with your opponents, and that to me is what gets violated when someone does something
And
offbeat like that.
Like Pittsburgh in 08, they lost against Detroit. We came second place. It was the worst feeling in the world. They came out the next year in 2009 and they won the cup.
Yeah.
Canada did it, like I said, Canada did it last year, silver medal, gold medal this year. Fully expect Sweden to do it next year. Totally possible. So,
you know, and Sweden does have 44-0, I think. Like they have 44 straight wins in round robin play, going back years.
Yeah.
In the junior, and they end up having difficulty in the playoffs, in the finals. But they have an exceptional team. They've been able to deliver exceptional teams to the World Juniors every year, no matter where they've been played.
Yeah.
They're very competitive, and it's not some vast mad conspiracy that they didn't win.
No, it's not. And some people said that we are typical Canadians and we hate Swedes. I took that really personal because we are the only people on YouTube talking about other leagues around the world, like the SHL in Sweden and in Finland and like everywhere. Like,
yeah.
We as Canadians, yeah. as people, we love Swedes.
Well,
I love the country of Sweden. I would love to visit there someday. And so I took that really personal when someone said that, because there's so much Swedish content on this channel. Like 15% of the people who watch the views on the channel are from Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to the podcast, there's twice as many Swedish people who listen to our podcast than Canadians. And they do that because we made some Swedish content and we had fun doing it. Like, it's...
Yeah.
I love the country. Like, for someone to say to me that they think that I'm just a typical Canadian, and I didn't understand that anyway, because I don't know any Canadian who dislikes Sweden or Swedish people in general. But I took that really personally, and that sucked to hear, because I've put so much effort into expanding this channel to other leagues around the world. So,
but you're going to have, you know, even if you have 100 Swedes, all it takes is two or three.
Yeah, I know.
And that's what's
Canadians,
going on
there's
here.
There's Canadians that are just like that too. So,
oh, God, yeah.
Those people will be everywhere.
Yeah.
I wanted to clarify one thing. I don't know specifically what I said in the video. I'm trying to think back, but I would like to not necessarily retract the statement, but maybe reword the statement. I believe I said I would never cheer for Elias Andersson because of what he did.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of regret saying that, because I understand he made a mistake. People make mistakes. I make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. We are human beings. It's just part of our nature. So I will retract that statement and say, how do I word this? I'm not saying I will cheer for him in the future, but I'm not saying that I won't cheer for him in the future. I think everybody deserves a second chance, but it doesn't mean that I'm not going to forget what he did. Sidney Crosby, I'm not a fan of Sidney Crosby because of the first 7 years in the league, his constant diving.
Who was a
Canadian, by the way. I'm Canadian.
Yeah.
He's Canadian. Like, this has nothing to do with nationality. If it was a Canadian, in fact, if it was a Canadian player that threw his medal in the audience, I would be way more harsh on him than I was on Elias Andersson.
Because he should know better.
Absolutely.
We know the Canadian hockey culture, and we know that a Canadian player would know better than to do that.
Don Cherry himself would fly to wherever the competition was and strangle that kid if it was a Canadian.
I bet he would.
Don Cherry would be so embarrassed.
Yeah, and maybe this isn't part of the Swedish hockey culture. Maybe they don't have the same, you know, keep your chin up, lose gracefully by the look of things. No, it's like if you don't win, then you're dirt.
And that's not a burn on Swedes or anything. It's like I had got a few messages that said, you know, I didn't really think that was disrespectful at all. That's just, you know, it shows a lot of heart and determination that all he cares about is winning. And if he's not winning, then nothing else matters. And that could be the mindset of from there. And that's totally fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But I think they're right when they say that the kid has determination. I mean, he stood there as a kid, or pretty much a man, crying on the ice in front of millions of people. Obviously, he has the heart and determination of, like, it's in his blood. Like, he's a winner. He's going to win. With a heart and determination like that, I can totally see this kid winning the Stanley Cup in the future or something. He wants it so bad. So I appreciate the heart and the gusto and the willingness and the want to get that gold medal and stuff. But I think it was just a mistake in us and an emotional mistake in a split decision that he probably regretted immediately.
I'm sure he did.
And he already has a silver medal, and I think he said that's why he threw it away, because, you know, I already have a silver medal. I don't want more salt in the wound. And I understand that. But I still disagree with his decision to throw it in the crowd. If he wants to throw it out, and then just wait until you go home and then throw it out, and then that's fine. Yeah. But I'm trying to think of other things that were said that we could reply to. Any final thoughts? Or?
Well, as you've been talking about the things that you've engaged with some of the viewers on in commentary, and then the things you said on the show, I've been thinking back to all the things I said and whether I would change anything, and I would not.
That's
so
fine.
I'm totally of the same view that I had before.
That's fine.
And it's just, you know, I didn't think there was I didn't think there was an overt or grossly unfair officiating in the game. I don't think it was a display of grace that that is owed to the game of hockey, from winners and losers both. And I still feel that way.
Yeah, that's totally fine. Yeah. So I hope, even if you disagree with us, at least hope you respect us for taking the time to respond to some of your comments and to elaborate a little more on our feelings. It's a controversial topic. It's a topic that it's risky to talk about regardless of your opinion, because there's always going to be people to disagree with you. So it's frustrating in a way, because, you know, I knew as soon as we made the video that people were going to leave some hate, and that's totally fine.
Oh, yeah.
That's the whole that's the whole point of YouTube, is where you can share your opinions. I just ask that people do it respectfully and constructively.
Mm-hmm.
For sure, because we can disagree and have our opinions, but we do it respectfully. We can share our opinions. We don't have to be rude and call people names and all that stuff.
No, I'd like to think so. And, you know, people have thrown hate at you because you profess to be a Montreal fan, but sometimes you're wearing other teams' jerseys or hats, and you're therefore somehow not as good as a real Montreal fan. I take the personal choice that I'm only going to wear Montreal things on air as long as Montreal is playing. Now, if they don't make it to the playoffs, I might decide to cheer for another team in the playoffs, who knows? Or if it's a different league, the AHL or the Swedish Elite League, I'll wear some other team's stuff.
Yeah, well, someone sent you an Alulia shirt.
And I've worn
it. And you've worn it already.
Twice, I believe. Oh, my goodness. But that doesn't make me a great person. I mean, someone sent me a free shirt and I wore it. You know, that wasn't really hard to do. So I'm not going to try to portray myself as a saint here. But obviously, I don't have any bias either.
You wore a Lulia shirt because you care about hockey in Sweden.
I care about the viewer that sent it.
Totally.
I think the viewer that sent that from Sweden is a wonderful person. And for me to wear the shirt, it's my way of respecting their gift to us on the channel. Because
that's why I'm wearing this hat. Absolutely.
So... one thing that I've really been impressed with that you've done in the last year, and this is really week 53 of Post to Post, is the international community of hockey fans that have gotten together and all focused some of their generosity towards you when it comes to the comments and the letters and the stories and even sometimes articles of clothing and swag that they've sent in. I think that's a wonderful thing, because those items are coming from all over the world. I
mean, completely.
You played on the ice the other day with a puck from Australia, you know, and you filmed a little bit of that, and it was kind of funny, and maybe someone will get to see that someday. But that's awesome, and that's what this channel has become. And I think that's why it hurts even more when you see hockey not being as universal and still being ghettoized. Into countries or into teams or into whatever.
North American media, and I think people just in general, have an obsession with only thinking that hockey exists in North America, and it doesn't. And when I started the channel, I knew that I wanted to talk about other leagues around the world because no one else was doing it, and I knew that there was a spot there on YouTube where someone could do that, and luckily it was successful, and people sending in stuff from Australia. I mean, this package right here, it's from Australia.
Yeah,
and this hat came from Sweden. Like, it's incredible.
It's an international show, very much.
I appreciate everyone, if you're watching in Sweden, if you're watching in Australia, if you're watching in Canada, or Uganda, wherever you're watching from, it's awesome. So thank you guys for, you know, being a part of the community, whether you agree or disagree with us. If you're watching and you didn't unsubscribe, then thank you. Even if you disagreed, we appreciate that. And if you did disagree, and if you want to dislike the video, that's fine too. That's no big deal. I understand. Like, I don't expect anyone to agree with our opinion, with my opinion.
No. It's that's what commentary is.
In fact, I don't even necessarily want people to agree with me. I'm just sharing my opinion because I have this channel. So
yeah.
I encourage anyone to share their opinion as well, whether you want to do that in a comment or make a video of your own or on Twitter. Doesn't matter. Just, we're all hockey fans. So let's be respectful and there's nothing wrong with a debate. Let's just get along.
Amen.
Amen. So thanks guys for watching. I appreciate it. If you have any questions or anything, leave them down in the comments. I'll do my best to answer them. And like this video if you liked it. And we'll see you in the next one. Adios.